Hello and welcome to GoldsQUAD Online. My name is Emily and I'm the Creative Wellbeing Admin Assistant at Derby Quad. GoldsQUAD is a relaxed, friendly group for anyone over 50 who is interested in creativity, learning new skills and trying new challenges in a supportive environment and working with other people. Sessions are led by creative practitioners and visiting artists. In today's GoldsQUAD workshop, Philippa Larkham is going to show you how to assemble your fabric books. She is also going to show you how to do a Sorbello stitch that you can use to finish off your fabric samples. You will need a needle and thread of your choice, and your fabric samples from our previous workshops, or any that you'd like to sew into your fabric book. Let's get started.
Hello, just wanted to talk to you about the last section of the fabric books that we've been working on. And I wanted to introduce you to, or reintroduce you to, a stitch that I really love. And I've just used it on this little tree here. It looks a little bit like cross stitch, but it's actually Sorbello stitch. And I just wanted to show you how to do that. And you need a, I'll just do it on a large scale so that hopefully it's easier to see. So I've got some thread here and I'm going to do a way knot. So just come in away from the work that I'm going to focus on, and you come up and you go over and make a bar like that, and then come down under where you first came up, so just on there. And then what we're going to do is do a little bit of weaving and then finish it off. So you come down underneath the bar and your needle needs to come over to the left, and then just give that a little tightening, then come down again over the bar and this time go to the right, and then you want to just make sure that your thread is caught underneath and pull through, and then you just pull them together and you've got a lovely little knot in the middle there, and then you finish it off by going underneath so that they're roughly in the same place. So if you imagine you've got A, B, C and D. So I'll do another one. Come up at A, go straight over to B, go on the diagonal to C, and that's set your first bar. Now come down underneath just the bar, not into the fabric, and go over to the left and make sure that your thread is out of the way here. Make a bit of a loop with your thread, come down underneath the bar again, and this time making sure that your thread goes underneath, and then back down at D. So I'll just do another one. And you can vary the sizes of these, or you can keep them all very much the same. Just pull that through. So up at A, over to B, diagonally underneath there to C, go underneath the bar, pull a little bit underneath the bar, wrap the thread underneath, tighten and come down. So you can try this with lots of different types of threads, so it's quite a nice one. And you can do very, very small threads, or you can do wool. Really nice with wool. You can vary again the length of the stitches too, so you can have spidery ones, or you can even, if you want to, overlap them and create some texture. Just underneath the bar, and once you get the technique, it's actually a really nice stitch to sit and do. It's very mindful. You can go on a little bit of a journey with it. Okay, so that's the Sorbello stitch, and I've used that on the piece of my fabric, so that I've made for my fabric book. And what I'd like to do today is also just show you how to assemble your little book once you've finished. So this is going to be my cover, And I've got a little bit of extra fabric here just in case I need it. I've just rolled it over at the moment and pinned it, so don't worry if you've got a little bit of extra fabric as well. And what you're going to do is take each of the leaves of your book and you fold them in half so that you've got some pages that are ready to go. So I've got mine, and work out what order you'd like them to go in. And then just leave them folded. And then take your cover and lay it out. And what we're going to then do is find the middle of the leaf that you're going to add in. You're going to put it onto the centre of where the cover is. I've marked that with a friction pen, but you could just pin it if you want to. And then just get a couple of pins, and again I'm using the lightweight pins, you know, not too big, and I'm going to just pin it on either side of what's going to be in effect the spine. I've done a little knot, and I'm going to do running stitches up that line, and we're going to do what's called a double running stitch, or sometimes called Holbein stitch, which is what they use in black work, so that it's the same on the front as it is on the back. And I found it easier doing it from the inside out, but by all means do it on the cover in if you prefer. So we're just going to make our row of stitches. I'm just using an embroidery needle size 7 to do this. I've got some thread that kind of works with what I've been doing. You can just use ordinary machine sewing thread for this, or you could use stranded thread, and you can make it thicker or finer depending on the effect that you'd like to create. Don't worry too much about the length of the stitches, because that's all part of the...
Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed the session. Please send any creations to creativewellbeing@darlingquad.co.uk.
And what I'm going to do is,
for more information on GoldsQUAD, please visit www.darlingquad.co.uk.
So this is what I mean by the
double
running stitch. So just backwards and forwards. So on the back, you've then got it starting to fill in. You get this really nice effect with it. And just take your time with it and enjoy the process. I think the other thing is, with this method, you've also got an opportunity, should you want it, to be able to add more leaves to your book. Perhaps if you learn more stitches, or if you have a lovely walk and you think, oh, I'd like to stitch that, or there's a little flower that's come up in the garden that I want to have a little play with. So just working your way through. Then you come up to the end here. And then when you're at the end, if you just take a little stitch, wrap your thread round a couple of times onto the needle, pull through, and that will give you a little knot that seals it. Just going to trim that. And then what I'd do is I'd unpin this and fold the leaf over and out of the way, and then you can add your next leaf of your little book, and again just pin that. So in effect it's right sides down to do this, and this little book is as nice then to look through on the back or inside, so it gives that lovely insight into how the stitches have been created. So that's how we're going to assemble the book. Keep doing that, adding on your leaves of your book, And I hope you enjoy doing that. Okay, thank you.
Thank you for watching. Please send a photograph of your creation to creativewellbeing@derbyquad.co.uk. For more information about GoldsQUAD, please visit derbyquad.co.uk.